It's good to be back here. On this episode of my TV show review series, I'll be reviewing the 2011 to 2013 show, and that one is the Looney Tunes show. Yeah, I remember watching this show on Cartoon Network, and I totally enjoyed it. The show is based on the original characters from Looney Tunes and Merrie Melodies cartoons. The show was created by three cartoon makers: Sam Register, who's the same person who created Hi Hi Puffy AmiYumi and the original Teen Titans, and Spike Brandt and Tony Cervoni, who are also the same dudes who created Scooby-Doo, Mystery Incorporated, and Duck Dodgers. The show was originally and currently airing on Cartoon Network, originally aired on Boomerang, and currently streaming on Max, formerly known as HBO Max, and Netflix. The show involves the same characters from Looney Tunes and Merrie Melodies cartoons from 1930s. Around the lives of Bugs Bunny, who owns a suburban home after inventing carrot peelers that pay him royalties, and Daffy Duck, who is Bugs' roommate, as they deal with different issues and problems that they encounter, some of the time caused by Daffy's rather bad lifestyle. The pair reside within a neighborhood inhabited by a number of notable Looney Tunes characters, including Yosemite Sam, Granny, Gossamer, and Speedy Gonzales, with both Bugs and Daffy having girlfriends in the form of Lola Bunny and Tina Russo, and a regular friendship with Porky Pig. Other Looney Tunes characters, like Elmer Fudd, Foghorn Leghorn, and Sylvester and Tweety, have less prominent roles but still partake in stories in their own way. Unlike other Looney Tunes productions, the series focused less on slapstick and fewer visual gags, in favor of more adult-oriented dialogue and significant sitcom elements including love triangles, employment and rooming. Episodes often contained at least two stories featuring Bugs and Daffy, and sometimes led by others in the show. Alongside the main plots of the episode, the story would often include a Merrie Melodies at 2 to 4 minute music video showcasing classic characters singing brand new original songs. For the first season only, the show also included new computer animated shorts involving Wile E. Coyote and the Roadrunner, and a new spate of antics between them. First thing we have is Bugs Bunny. Bugs is a funny rabbit in this show. He's known for his catchphrase, "Hey, what's up, Doc?" Of course you realize this means war, and that's the end. He's likable, funny, witty, stubborn, and sarcastic in this show. Number 2, Daffy Duck. In this show, he's a egocentric and selfish, but not the point that he becomes unlikable in this show. Number 3, Porky Pig. He's a funny pig, and that's it. I have nothing to say about it. Number 4, Lola Bunny. Although she didn't make it to the 1930s Looney Tunes and Merrie Melodies cartoons, she did made to the Space Jam movie from 1996, and she even made it to Baby Looney Tunes. She's a great love interest for Bugs Bunny. Number 5, Tina Russo. And although she didn't made it to the 1930s cartoons, and even other Looney Tunes cartoons, she's the newest in the Looney Tunes cartoons. She's also great love interest for Daffy Duck. Number 6, Speedy Gonzales. This mouse has a skill to speak Spanish. His Spanish is great. They even introduce the same characters. That includes Sylvester Cat, Tweety Bird, Tasmanian Devil, Petunia Pig, Marvin the Martian, and this goes on. The show doesn't went away after its show got cancelled in 2013. Let's not forget about the direct-to-video that was released in 2015 on DVD from Warner Brothers. Home Entertainment, Looney Tunes, Rabbits Run. The movie was great. This show gets a 10 out of 10. This show is a great masterpiece of the modern Cartoon Network, and it's a great masterpiece for the modern Looney Tunes. This concludes this review.